Hello dear students, myself Dr. Sachin Gurole, assistant professor from Department of Zoology, KTHM College, Nasik. So this video is for class SYBSC semester 4 and we are already learning the subject that is animal diversity 4 for the 4th semester. And in the previous lectures we have started the chapter number 1 that is introduction to class Reptilia. And in previous two lectures, we have already learned the salient features of the class Reptilia and the classification of class Reptilia. And in this video, we are going to learn the topic that is venomous and non-venomous snake and how to identify that venomous and non-venomous snake with the help of identification keys. Let's see first of all the introduction. What is meant by venomous and non-venomous snake? So if you see the snakes which are found in our country India, they are particularly the majority of the snakes, they are non-venomous. That is, they do not contain a venom which is harmful to the human actually. Now in India, there are about the 330 species of the snakes, they are well known, and of these 330 species, only the 69 species of the snakes which are found in India, they are categorized as the venomous snake. And of these 69 species again, nearly 29 species of the snakes are the sea snakes or the coral snakes, and only about 40 species of the land snakes, they are known to be the venomous, which is found in our India. Now, venomous snakes are so called as because they have a characteristic poison apparatus in the head region of these snakes. Now, it also bears a pair of large teeth, and these large teeth are called as the fangs. And these fangs are located in the upper jaws. Now, venomous snake bite leaves the two large circular puncture marks on the skin that are caused because of the fangs only. So, after the snake bite, by having the impression of these two circular puncture marks on the skin, whether these marks are present or absent, on the basis of which we can able to judge whether that snake bite is happened from whether venomous snake or whether it was a non-venomous snake, because these fangs are generally absent into the non-poisonous snakes, okay, or the non-venomous snake. So non-venomous snakes leaves many small prick marks which is due to the presence of the multiple teeth, but they generally the fangs are absent in non-venomous snakes. Okay, so from that we can able to identify whether it is the venomous snake or the non-venomous snake. But particularly the snakes can be categorized as a venomous snake and non-venomous snake by having a certain keys, taxonomical keys particularly. So the identification keys to distinguish venomous and non-venomous snakes are very easy. From the morphological appearance, if we able to snap a good close-up photographs of the snakes in any incident scene, we can able to determine whether that snake is belongs to the venomous category or whether it is the non-venomous category. So today we are going to learn these pictorial keys so that we can able to identify whether that snake is venomous or the non-venomous. So before start with the keys, so one can should know the idea about how to read the keys. So these are the dichotomous keys, which contains a two points. You have to follow that point. If the description in that particular key, if it is matches with your observation, so it will give you conclusion. If that first key is not applicable, then you have to leave that key and you have to read or you have to follow your characteristic of the snake into the second key. And ultimately, as you go on reading the keys, you will get to know which kind of the snake you will found So let's see first of all the first key, that is about the tail shape. Now the first A key is that if the snake is a marine, that is they are found into the marine habitat or into the sea water, and if the tail is laterally compressed or like, then this is the indication of the venomous snake. So here in this diagram you can see the sea snake or the coral snake, they are usually provided with a flat tail, and this flat tail is present in such a kind of the snakes is because of for the purpose of swimming. For the purpose of swimming, so they are aquatic actually, and for the purpose of swimming they are provided with a such a laterally compressed tail, which is a oar-like and is an indication of the venomous snake. So all the snakes which are provided with a such a laterally compressed body, compressed tail, and if they are living into the seawater, all such a kind of the snakes are categorized as a venomous snake. So for example, the sea snakes like a hydrophis and enhydrina, so these are the examples of the sea snake where you will find a laterally compressed tail. Now suppose the snake in which for which you are identifying or we are which you are trying to identify, if it is do not showing a such a kind of the laterally compressed tail, then you have to skip this key and you have to read the next key. So what is the next key? The next key is 1B. If the snake is a terrestrial and if the tail is a cylindrical or rounded but never laterally compressed, then you have to go to the key number 2. For that, what is the exactly the key number 2? That is, you have to observe the belly or the ventral scales of the snake. So the key is very simple. If the tail is a cylindrical or rounded and if the snake is terrestrial or the land snake, then it may be poisonous or it may be venomous or it may be non-venomous snake. So at that time you have to identify the snake with the help of what kind of the belly scales they are provided, because the venomous snake as well as non-venomous snake, they may have the similar rounded or the cylindrical tail. So let's see the second key, the belly or the ventral scale. So the first key in 2A, that is, if all the belly or the ventral scales are small in size, they are continuous with that of the dorsal scale. So if you see this diagram, you will found that if all the scales which are present on the belly or from the ventral side, if they are small, uniform, and they are continuous with that of the dorsal scale, so is an indication of the non-venomous snake. So in non-venomous snake, you will found the uniform small belly scales which are generally continuous with that of the dorsal scale. Okay, so if you will not found a such a kind of the uniform scale, then you have to go for the next key. So next key is, if the ventral or belly scales are not fully broad to cover the belly, so like this in the second diagram here you can see, so there are certain ventral shields are there which is located at a ventral side, and but these ventral shields are not completely overlapping the ventral part or not overlapping or covering the whole belly region. So again, it is an indication of the non-venomous snake. For example, such a kind of the pattern of the scales on the belly, you will found into the snakes like that of the python. Python in Marathi is also known as a rock python or Ajgar. Okay, so which is a non-venomous snake. So they are provided with a such a kind of the ventral shield which do not fully cover the belly part. Okay, so again, if the character is not applicable to your snake, then you have to follow the next key. The next key is, if the belly or ventral scales are broad and they are fully covering the whole belly surface. Okay, so at that time, so that kind of the snake again may be venomous snake or maybe non-venomous snakes, but particularly, so these kind of the scales are majorly found into the venomous snake. But if again still there is a confusion, because some of the non-venomous snake also having a such a kind of the enlarged ventral shield, which is covering the whole belly part, and hence to avoid ambiguity you have to follow the next key. And the next key is you have to observe the dorsal scales which are present on the head region. Okay, so before that, let's see the few of the characteristics just we have learned for the first two keys. So here we have learned, if the snake is living into the marine habitat, that is in the sea water, and if the tail is laterally compressed or the flat tail, so is a indication of the venomous snake. And usually the all the sea snakes are the venomous. And in the second, we have learned, if the tail is a rounded or somewhat cylindrical tail, so that cylindrical tail is present into the terrestrial snake that may be categorized as the non-venomous snake as well as venomous snake. For example, here in this diagram, you can able to see the three kinds of the snakes. So first one is a python, which is commonly known as Asgar. In Asgar, you can see the cylindrical tail is there, or the quite heavily built rounded tail is there. Then second snakes you can see here in the diagram, that is Thais mucosus, which is commonly known as a rat snake, or in Marathi is referred as a Dhaman. Okay, so here you can see the tail is again the cylindrical one. And the third snake here, the that is a Bangaris. That Bangaris is commonly known as a crate, in Marathi is referred as a Manyar. Okay, so here in all these three snakes, first of all, these are the terrestrial snake, and if you see their tail is a cylindrical one or is a rounded one. Means what the key says, the cylindrical tail may be present in a venomous snake as well as non-venomous snake. Okay, and then after you have to observe the belly scale. If the belly scales are small and uniform, continuous with the dorsal, then is an indication of the non-venomous snake. If the belly scale are not fully covering the belly surface, then again it is the indication of the non-venomous snake, such as a python. But again, if the ventral scales are broad, they are covering fully belly area, is maybe the characteristic of the non-venomous or the venomous snake. So at that time, you have to follow the next key, that is, you have to observe the dorsal scales of the head. So let's see what is the key for the dorsal scales of the head. So first key 3A, if the head is a triangular and all the dorsal scales of the head are uniformly small, so this is the indication of the venomous snake. And that venomous snake maybe comes under the category of the viper. So all the vipers, they are generally provided with a such a triangular shaped head region, and this triangular head, they are generally provided with a small scales, and they are having a uniform pattern. But again, there are different kinds of the vipers are there. So to accurate identification, we have to follow the next key. So next key is, if there is a loreal pit absent between the nostril and eye, so is an indication of pitless viper. So here in the diagram you can see, so this is a triangular head, the scales are small and uniform, the eyes are there, then the nostril is there, but there is no loreal pit present in between the eyes and nostril, is an indication of whenever the pit is absent or loreal pit is absent, these snakes are the venomous snake, but they comes under the category of pitless viper. Okay, now another characteristic to identify the pitless viper is that if the subchordal scales are double, subchordal in the sense, if you see the tail region just after the anal region, if the ventral scales, they occurs in a double row, okay, that scales are referred as the subchordal scale. This is the confirmation that the snake is a pitless viper, and the pitless viper, the example is the Vipera russelli, or which is commonly known as a Russell's viper, okay, which is commonly found in India in a Himalayan region particularly. Okay, now again, if the subchordal scales are only single, means again at the ventral scales after the anal region, that scales are referred as a subchordal. if they are not occur in a double row but they are single, again it is also indication of the venomous snake, but that snake is known as the Indian saw-scaled viper, which is also a pitless viper, and the example is Ichis carinatus. Okay, so these are the again pitless viper, but these pitless viper, they are not provided with a double subchordal scale. So according to the whether the subchordal scales are double or single, again that viper can be differentiated. If the double subchordals are there, then it is Russell viper. If single subchordal scales are there, then it is the Indian saw scaled viper, which is known as a Ichis carinatus. Okay, now suppose if the head is a triangular, the scales are uniform, but there is a loreal pit present between the eyes and nostril. For example, see in this diagram. So here this is a loreal pit, this one is the eye and this one is a nostril. So what the next key is offering? So if the loreal pit is present between the eyes and nostril, is an indication of the pit viper. Pit viper in the sense they are provided with a loreal pit. So the examples of the loreal pit is Agistrodon, or it is also known by the another name genus, which is a synonym, that is Ancestrodon, which is commonly known as a Himalayan pit viper. So it is also found in a Himalayan region, and hence commonly known as a Himalayan pit viper. Then another example of the pit viper is the Lachesis, which is commonly known as the Bushmasters. Okay, so this is the indication of the venomous snake. Okay, so again I am going to differentiate between the Russell viper and or the pit viper and pitless viper. If the head is a triangular, scales are uniform, and there is no loreal pit between the eyes and nostril, then it is pitless viper. Again, if the pitless viper is there, if the subchordal scales are double, then this is the Russell viper. And when the subchordal scales are single, then it is the Indian saw-scaled viper. But if the loreal pit is present between the eyes and nostril, so that snake is again venomous snake, but it comes under the category of the pit viper. Okay, and the example is the Himalayan pit viper or the Bushmaster. So these are the example of pit viper. Now suppose if these both these characters are not applicable to your snake, then you have to skip this character and you have to get the next key. So what is the next key? If the dorsal side of the head has both small scales and the large shield. So here in the third diagram you can see the head region is there, and if you see the dorsal surface is provided with a small scales as well as large shield. So if such a kind of the pattern of a scales you will found on the head of the snake, then that snake maybe belongs to the non-venomous category or maybe venomous category. So at that time you have to follow the next key, that is fourth key. You have to observe the vertebral as well as the labial scales. Okay, so before start whatever discussion we had, just you can see, so this is a pitless viper, which is known as a Russell viper. So here you can see the triangular head, the scales are uniform, eyes are there, nostril are there, but there is no loreal pit, hence this is a pitless viper. In the second image you can see the head is a triangular, the scales are uniform small on the dorsal side of the head. So here you can see the eye. Here this is a nostril, and in between the eye and nostril there is a loreal pit. So loreal pit is present when means this snake is belongs to the category that is the pit viper. So these are the full photograph of the two snakes. That is, this is a pitless viper known as a Russell viper, and this is a green pit viper, which is provided with a loreal pit. Okay, so if both these characteristic is not there, if the scales are small and large shield, then you have to observe the next key, that is vertebrals, and fourth infralabial and third supralabial scales. So the key is, if the vertebral in the sense whatever scales which are present at the vertebral column, exactly at the center of the dorsal side, which is known as a vertebral scales, as they are lies on the vertebral column. So if the vertebrals are larger than that of the other scales and ventral side of the lower jaw has the hexagonal 6 infralabial shield larger than that of the other. So this character is suggesting that the snake may be venomous snake. For example, so here in this diagram you can see, so this is a piece of the scales on the dorsal side. So these are all are the dorsal scales, but this is the vertebral scale. So if vertebral scales are large, hexagonal, and they are larger than that of the adjacent scale, then and another characteristic, that is the fourth infralabial scale, if it is the large, then is an indication of the venomous snake, and that snake may be the Bangaris. Bangaris is commonly known as a crate, and in Marathi is known as the Manya, which is the deadliest poisonous snake again. Okay, and the poison of the crate is the neurotoxic, as it is going to attack on the nervous system. Okay, so from these two characteristics, you can able to identify the crate. If that characters are not applicable, then you have to observe the next key. So if the vertebral scales are not larger than that of the other scale, and the third supralabial scale, if it touches with the nostril, eyes and the nose shield, then again it is an indication of the venomous snake, and that snake may be cobra or the coral snake or maybe king cobra. So here in this diagram you can see again the eyes are there, this is nostril is there, and this one is the upper jaw. Okay, so the scales can be numbered. So this is a first supralabial, then second supralabial, and this is a third supralabial. Now if the third supralabial scale, if it is touches with the eyes and nostril, then is an indication of the venomous snake, and that may be the cobra or maybe the coral snake. But again, for the distinct characteristic features of the snakes which are provided with a such a third supralabial skull touching the eyes and nostril, is that if the neck is provided with a hood and with or without spectacle mark. Okay, so if the hood is there and that hood may be provided with a spectacle or the binocillate mark, or whether that binocillate mark or the spectacle mark may be absent, again is an indication of the venomous snake, and that snake may be the cobra, which is commonly whose scientific name is a Naja Naja, and the Ophiophagus, which is the commonly known as the king cobra. So in both cobra as well as king cobra, you will found that they are provided with a hood. Okay, and those snakes, they are provided with a hood and producing a hissing sound. In Marathi we called it as a nag. Okay, so all these nag, they are comes under the this key. Okay, now if suppose the hood is absent and coral spots on the belly, they are present, that snake may be again the venomous snake, and this time this kind of the venomous snakes may be coral snake or the Asian coral snake. For example, Microrus and the Calophis, these are the example of the coral snake, in which you will found that the third supralabial skull is touching the nostril, eyes and the nose shield. Okay, so accordingly, whether the hood is present or not, further you can able to classify whether it is cobra, king cobra, or whether it is the coral snake. Now suppose all above mentioned characteristic feature, that is 4a and 4b, if they are absent, then at this time 100% all such snakes are comes under the category of non-venomous snake. And the example of non-venomous snake is a Thias, means is in Marathi is known as the Dhaman and commonly known as the rat snake. And another example is a Erex, which is commonly known as the sand boa. So here again we can able to see the keys very distinctly here. So first of all, we can see the vertebral scale. So here this is a photograph of the crate. So here at the center, you can see, follow the pointer, you can see the large hexagonal scales which are present on exactly the middle of the dorsal side on the vertebral column. And these scales are known as the vertebral scales, which are easily see, you can see that they are larger in size than that of the peripheral. So is an indication of the venomous snake, and that snake is a crate or the bungarus. And from the ventral side, you can see, you can able to see the fourth infralabial scale, but actually in the field, it is very difficult to observe the fourth infralabial scales as it is located from the ventral side. Okay, but yes, from this hexagonal large vertebral scale, it is enough to identify the snake is a venomous and is a crate. Now, if this character is absent, then here you can see the head of the cobra. So this is a nostril and this one is the eye. Okay, so this first supralabial scale, second supralabial scale, and this is the third supralabial scale. And you can easily see that the third supralabial scale is making a contact with the eyes and the nostril or the nasal nose shield. So this is enough to identify the venomous snake. They comes under the category of the cobra or maybe the coral snake. And accordingly, whether hood is present or not, they can further be differentiated as the cobra and the coral snake, because this third supralabial touching the nose and eyes is a common for the cobra as well as coral. But in case of coral snake, hood is absent, while in case of cobra and king cobra, hood is always present. They are maybe provided with a binocelate mark, or maybe that binocelate mark is absent. Now suppose all these characters we have discussed, if it is absent at that time, the snake is a non-venomous one. So but here we can see the coral spots are present on the belly. So these are the examples of the venomous snake and the microrurus, which is commonly known as a coral snake, and Calophis, which is commonly known as the Asian coral snake. So they are also provided with a third supralabial scale, but the hood is absent. And if all above mentioned characteristic in the 4A and 4B, if they are absent, then the snakes are 100% non-venomous snake, and that may be the thais, that is the rat snake, commonly known as a dhaman in Marathi, and maybe erex, which is known as a sand boa, or in Marathi we can refer as the mandul, or maybe is referred as a gan mandul. Okay, so with the help of these taxonomic keys or pictorial keys, one can able to identify the snake whether it is venomous or non-venomous. So herewith we have finished with our practical. Now with this practical, you can at least able to categorize the snake in whether it is as the non-venomous snake or maybe is a venomous snake. So I hope all of you understand this practical. So thank you. Thank you very much.